Hi, welcome to a new video. Today we'll be looking at how to de-squeeze with an anamorphic lens on your smartphone. I've got a nice beautiful setting here. There's one thing I forgot, I always tend to forget things. Today it's the Osmo Mobile that I forgot to bring with me. On the other hand, it saves me some weight, so I'm fine, and for today's tutorial it isn't really needed. So let's have a look on how to de-squeeze anamorphic footage. It doesn't really matter which smartphone or which anamorphic lens you'll be using. I myself will be using my iPhone 10 for this tutorial, along with the anamorphic lens from Moment. But you can also use another smartphone, can be an Android system, can be an iPhone. You can use the anamorphic lens from Moondog. De-squeezing works the same for either lens. First steps first, that's connecting the lens to your smartphone, the Moment anamorphic lens. For the iPhone 10 you have to set it up correctly, I've already done that with mine. There are a few apps you can use to de-squeeze your footage while filming. The two that I prefer are the Moment app, both available for Android and iOS, or the Filmic Pro app, which is also available on both platforms. If you open up the Moment app with the anamorphic lens attached to it, it won't automatically recognize which lens is on your phone. But if you tap the circle button, which should be either at the top right if your phone is in portrait mode, or if it's in landscape mode, the way that I'm holding it, on the top left corner, there's a circle button, hit that button, select the lens you're using, in this case the anamorphic lens, and you can see that the image instantly de-squeezes, and where your footage will be saved, de-squeezed. If you prefer to use Filmic Pro instead of the Moment app, setting up the anamorphic lens is almost just as simple. First, we start up Filmic Pro, and then in the lower right corner, you'll see a small cogwheel. Tap that, hit the hardware button, and all you have to do is enable the Moondog anamorphic adapter. This also works for the Moment lens because the aspect ratio is exactly the same, and here's your de-squeezed image already, and this is also how it saves on your phone. De-squeeze on your phone already, but what if you use an app that can't de-squeeze, or maybe you've used a setting that doesn't allow for de-squeezing, or maybe you simply forgot to de-squeeze? Is there a problem? Not at all. If you come back home, you've imported the footage on your computer, you can simply de-squeeze the images either in Adobe Premiere or in Final Cut Pro. I don't have Premiere, so I'll be using Final Cut Pro for this tutorial. If you want to learn how to do it in Premiere, you can simply look it up on YouTube. There are videos where it's explained how to do it. In Final Cut Pro and in Premiere, it's roughly the same ID, it's just some buttons that are on a different place. If you watch this tutorial, you should be able to do it in Premiere as well. I've got this footage here that's from Amsterdam, and as you can see, it's all pretty squeezed. There's this truck here that's just a bit too tiny, and we want to de-squeeze this footage. In order to do that, we go to File, New Project, and in my case I've got the extended settings, but if you only see the automatic settings, you want to click on Use Custom Settings. You can give your project a name. I'm going to name this Amsterdam because this is shot in Amsterdam. The event de-squeezing is fine, starting time code, nothing to change there. And by default, you'll notice that it says video 1080p HD in a resolution of 1920 by 1080. And that's the part we want to change. First, we click on the format, and we're going for a custom format. You can see it still shows a 1080p default format, and the 1080p for height is just fine. We only want to change the width, and in this case that's 1920, and we need to have the de-squeezed format for it. And to find out what that is, all you have to do is look on the side of your anamorphic lens. There it says 1.33 times. So that's what we're going to calculate, 1920 times 1.33. And then we see that we need roughly 2,553.54 pixels. So I'm going to use 2553. 1080 was good. All the other settings, you can change them the way you want them to be. I'll leave them as they are for now. There we are. And as you can see, the canvas now is already the cinematic white canvas, but there's nothing on there. So I'm gonna drag this clip onto the timeline. And as you can see, let's take this truck for instance. The footage is still squeezed. It doesn't automatically de-squeeze. That's something that I have to do myself. In this case, I make sure that the footage that I want to de-squeeze is selected. Then within the inspector, I've got mine open already, but if you have yours closed, you can click on these sliders here to open up the settings. And then you can see that within transform, I've got mine shown already, but it could be that your transform options are still hidden. And you just have to click on the show button that's in the same line. And we want to scale something. In this case, we don't need to scale the y-axis. We only need to scale the x-axis. Right now, it's set to 100%. Again, we look at the side of the lens. It says 1.33. In this case, we're gonna remove the dot. We're just gonna say 133%. There we go. And now if we take a look at this truck, it's already nicely de-squeezed. The only thing that's still going on here is that apparently the tripod that I used, I didn't line it up perfectly, so everything is slightly angled. If you do want to change that, you can just click on the transform button below the viewer. And there's a button in the middle. We don't want that because that's used to move the image around within the canvas. To the right of that, there's a little circle that I'm gonna drag, and I'm gonna extend it so that I can drag it more carefully. I'm gonna make sure that my footage looks more level. I think roughly like this. And if you're happy with the angle, just be sure to slightly scale up the image so that everything still fits within the canvas. If you shoot at 4K and you use an output of 1080, it's fine to lose a few pixels. You won't see it even with 1080p. You probably won't even notice. Hit the done button. And here's my footage, nicely de-squeezed. Computer still needs a little bit of time to render all of this. As you could see, it's not too difficult to do on the computer. Just make sure your canvas has the right aspect ratio, which is the width times 1.33, and make sure to scale the x-axis by 133%. And that should give you the nice cinematic look if you forgot to de-squeeze on your phone, if you were unable to de-squeeze on your phone. If you still have any questions about how to de-squeeze with the anamorphic lens, make sure to ask them down below in the comments. The next video will probably still be about lenses, but it won't be specifically the anamorphic lens, but it will be some different sort of lenses. If you want to get a reminder when that video has come online, make sure to subscribe to my channel. For now, that's it. Have a great day.